So we are in year 2020, and this is my classroom tour. I realized I didn't do one at the beginning of the year, and I felt like my classroom has held up pretty well. So I just wanted to show you guys how I set up. So first thing first, when you come in the room, you see it says welcome, and there's a picture of me. We have our calendar and our hours, because students always ask what time lunch is. So then you come in here, there's a little area for them to get a pencil, paper, and colors if they need it. I have more than pencils than that, but I find that if you only put two or three out, they tend to return them a little bit better. Then we also have Kleenex. Then we have our calendar. Usually the students do that. Then we're gonna go to I actually share textbooks with the teacher next door, which is why they're always in the little cart. And then I just have a place where I can put my lesson plans, which is very simple because we're just gonna return tomorrow. It's gonna be a pretty easy day since the kids tend to come in waves. Some of them take a little bit longer. I have a seating area right there for flexible seating. Students can choose to sit there. My policy on flexible seating is just if you get here on time, you can sit wherever you want. And if I ask you to move, move. It's almost never been a problem. So then I have my timekeeper, which says the word hora, means time in Spanish. And I have a couch, which is very popular. Actually, my sister gave it to me. It was an old couch from IKEA. It's the top part is washable, so it's really, really awesome. And this is generally the way I have the lighting in my classroom, just because the kids, have so much energy and you want to unwind, and they just prefer the lights being off. Then I just have my microwave for myself and my fridge. You can see just pictures of my kids. The kids, get to see all that good stuff. I have a coffee maker because I drink coffee several times a day. This might be Ray J. Cole quote. It's in his song. And I just wanted to show the kids, something about me. This is just a Sun C. If you've ever taught in middle school, you know why these are so necessary. I teach Spanish, like I said previously, so I felt like this frame was perfect. Don't forget your roots. We want them to be proud of who they are and, their culture. Then my seating is pretty, standard, and I like that my desk is all the way back here. I'm almost never here, but then if I ever sit down, I can see everyone. Then we have our grammar wall. It is empty at the moment just because once we took finals, I had to take everything down so my kids wouldn't use their notes, the ones that we had on the wall, but it will shortly get filled as we progress through the weeks. Then we have a mirror because middle school students are very vain. They start caring about their looks and they just want to know, how's my hair look? How does, whatever. So I just put a mirror up so then that prevents them from going to restrooms since, they're safer in the classroom. We have our school motto, we do soar. And then lastly, which brings us full circle, is just my work turn-in area. So I teach seven different classes, and the reason you don't see the other basket there is because it's on the other side, since that is a different class. I don't want to confuse my kids. But every basket is labeled. The students are leaving all their items there. That way, there's never an excuse. I don't have a notebook. I don't have a pencil. Everything is provided for them. I just need their body in here. And that one just says, en español, por favor, because my students are expected to speak in Spanish the majority of the time. Actually, 100% of the time, although sometimes that's a little bit more difficult. That's it. That's my trash can, and that's my classroom tour. I hope you guys enjoyed it.